This war is going to stop everything. We can't tell what will happen. I've got the children to consider, so here I am. I was at Hickson's before 9. The little lady was very flushed and bright-eyed. Her fair hair was disordered, her hat a trifle askew. She had an air of enjoying unwanted excitements. "All the gold's been hoarded, too," she said, with a crow of delight in her voice. "Faber says that probably our checks won't be worth that in a few days. He rushed off to London to get gold at his clubs, while he can. I had to insist on Hickson taking a check. 'Never,' I said, 'will I deal with you again, never, unless you do.' Even then he looked at me almost as if he thought he wouldn't." "It's famine," she said, turning to Mr. Britling. "I've laid hands on all I can. I've got the children to consider."
"But why is it famine?" asked Mr. Britling.
"Oh, it is," she said.
"But why?"
"Faber understands," she said. "Of course it's famine." "And would you believe me," she went on, going back to Mrs. Britling, "that man Hickson stood behind his counter, where I've dealt with him for years, and refused absolutely to let me have more than a dozen tins of sardines. Refused, point blank. I was there before 9, and even then Hickson's shop was crowded. Crowded, my dear." "What have you got?" asked Mr. Britling, with an inquiring movement towards the automobile. She had got quite a lot. She had 2 sides of bacon, a case of sugar, bags of rice, eggs, a lot of flour,